सर रिकॉर्डिंग ऑन करा सर।
हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई होप आई एम क्लियरली ऑडिबल, इज इट सो?
यस सर।
ओके, थैंक यू। या थैंक यू वेरी मच। आई एम डॉक्टर रायबुले वीएन, वेलकम्स यू ऑल फॉर दिस शॉर्ट मीटिंग। टुडे वी आर हियर to discuss about internship activity. This activity we are planning for our SE and TE all branch students, that is computer, ENTC and mechanical. We are the team of faculty members to coordinate this activity in our institute. Along with me, we are having with us Dr. Wag Madam, group leader of this particular activity. Then we are having with us Dr. Patil sir from mechanical department, then Professor Devre madam from computer department, then Professor Pansare sir from ENTC department. So this is the particular team we are going to coordinate this particular activity in our institute. As you know, our college is affiliated to SPPU, so the whatever the syllabus given by university, we are implementing that. But as you all of you know, there is always some gap between present syllabus which you are undergoing and the actual industry need. Always there is a gap. So this gap, if you want to bridge up, one of the way is nothing but the internship. During the study itself, you can undergo some kind of internship and gain the industrial experience, work experience and practical skill in the field which you have interest in the particular case. So that kind of thing is there to cope up with this particular syllabus gap. Now, you know, the internship is going to become mandatory by various higher bodies, maybe AICT, UGC, university, but this will be become mandatory in due course of time. I think we should not wait for that, as this particular internship is going to give different dimensions for the future career of the students. We should not wait for that to become mandatory. So I appreciate the efforts taken by this particular team of the faculty, Wag Madam, then Patil sir, Pansare sir, Shalaka Madam. So they have taken initiative to make at least some awareness session about the internship so that every students can participate in this particular activity. If you see the present scenario, one of the biggest challenge in front of the fresher budding engineer while applying for the job is nothing but the lack of working experience, practical skill in the required field of the industry. In today's world, you know, every employer is looking for a best candidate, a best candidate with all three dimensions, the whatever they are looking for. So all-round person, they are looking for these particular jobs. And if you lack something in yourself during the study, maybe kind of practical skill, maybe kind of working experience, so you will be set aside. And in this competitive world, there will be less scope available with us. Nowadays, you know, completing just a conventional engineering degree is not good enough for us. Along with that, we should have other qualities also to get a good job. And these qualities we have to achieve in the form of various ways. One of the ways is nothing but internship. So during internship, you can understand the how the industry atmosphere is there, how the regular process of the industry is going to take place in the working hours of that particular industry, how the communication we supposed to do with the higher authorities in the industry. So such kind of observations, such kind of working experience you can undergo during this internship period. You might be knowing 2-3 years before, the industries were recruiting the trainee engineers, and they usually invest something, some resources on training of the fresher. But the today's scenario is very different. Any employer don't want to invest their resources on the freshers for the training. They are expecting the engineers who are ready to do job on actual field. They don't want to invest their money on the training part. And if we are not ready to work on the actual field, then we will be set aside. So one of the way to groom our students for this is nothing but internship. And in that way, this internship is very important for us. So I will not take much time, as our team members, my faculty colleagues are going to explain each and every aspect of internship activity. Maybe it is related with the what are the different ways of internship available with us, what are the different government agencies, maybe NGOs are giving internship to the students, maybe some kind of paid internship, some kind of free internship, and these are the different schemes available from the government of India, government of Maharashtra. So each and every details about this internship activity, our team member is going to explain. They have prepared very nice PPT. So I will not take much time on this, but at the last, I will appeal to everyone, take active participation in this particular internship activity, because it is going to very useful after your graduation. And not only that, during academics also, this internship is playing very important role. Once you complete the internship in some industry, you can connect this internship topic with your project, the final year project, maybe a mini project in third year, if you are having. So the academics also, you can strengthen with the help of this particular internship activity. So as an institute, we are trying ourselves to connect the industries, maybe government agencies, maybe some NGOs. But again, there is a limitations to establish the contact by the institute. In that case, if anybody from the students is having some contacts through their individual network, maybe their parents working in some industry, maybe some friends working in some industry, and internship facility, if it is available in that particular industry, you just share all those details with us. We will take a follow-up. We will communicate with them, and we will try to see that our each and every student during our course undergo at least one internship program, and they can get industrial experience, industrial exposure during the study itself. So I will not take much time. Thank you very much. Now I hand over this session to Dr. Wag Madam. Over to you, Madam.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Yeah. Okay. Am I audible?
Yes, Pansar, madam. You are audible.
Am I audible? Yes, okay. Yeah. Yes, good morning, everyone. Good morning. Okay. So, agenda for today's presentation is what is internship and types of internship. Okay, I'll go through this part. What is internship and different types of internships, documents and formats regarding internship. After that, different private and government internship schemes. And last one is that how to get internship. Okay, so we'll go through this agenda. Is next slide, sir. So what is internship? Okay, so if you go through the internship definition or just what is internship, so an internship is a period of work experience offered by an organization for a limited period of time. So if you just go through this thing here, three things are very important. What are these three things? So it's a work experience. Second one is that it's offered by an organization. So second important word is here, organization. And third one is that your limited period of time. So this work experience may be anything. Okay, anything means which are the types of internships you are going to select it that comes under your work experience. It may be a research internship, it may be a professional internship which you will perform in the company, or it may be your project related internships, or it may be your NGO related internship. Okay, so second one is that organization. So what is this organization? That organization will provide you internship. Okay, so it may be a government organization or private organization also. And last one is that your limited period of time. So what is this limited period? It may be 10 days internship also, or it may be 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, or 6 months also. So that period. So you can say that an internship is a period of work experience offered by an organization for a limited period of time. Next slide, sir. So why internship for engineering students? Okay, so see, these internships, obviously you are going to perform along with your graduation. Okay, so this degree is not enough for a student to secure a job, good job. They need some industrial experience, and this industrial experience definitely you will get it with the help of internships. That's why this internship for engineering student is important. Along with that, one of the most common and biggest issue to students deal with when they are applying for the job is work experience internship, useful for all engineering students' careers. See, whenever you are going to apply for the job, for example, there are 10 students are there, and from these 10 students, that 2 students, they have completed their internship into that specific period. Okay, so definitely that company will give a preference to the students who have completed this interview. They will give the preference to the students, those who have completed internships. Okay, so this internship is very important for to gain knowledge also, and as well as to apply for job. So it's means a big benefit for you when you will apply or when you will come in the market with that internship experience. Yes, next slide, sir. Okay, so what are the benefits? Okay, so these benefits are two ways, means both the ways. Benefits are for the intern also, as well as benefits for the employers also. So how this benefited to intern? See, this help to gain a relevant skill and experience in a particular field and create possibility for permanent employer. Okay, for example, if you'll do a internship in a company for 2 months or 1 month summer internship, okay, so they will just observe you. So it may happen that if your work is good or whatever, that way according to their parameter, okay, you have done a good job, so definitely they will offer you PPO. What is that PPO? PPO is a pre-placement offer. Okay, so no need to go for your campus interview and all these things. Before that, you will have a placement offer in your hand. Okay, so help to gain relevant skill, it's a very important benefit for the interns, as well as experience in a particular field, which create a possibility for permanent employment. Okay, and what is the benefits for employer? See, employers recruit employees from their best interns who have known capabilities, thus saving time and money in the long run. See, whenever you will do the internship in the company, so those employers will observe you. Okay, they will just observe you in all perspective. Okay, how you are behaving with your colleagues, okay, how you are handling pressure, or how you are performing that particular task, okay, how you are following that deadlines. They will observe you in each and every angle. Okay, and if they find that yes, this person is a suitable for our company, okay, so that's why means they will offer you that PPO. So this will save their time and money also to search for a suitable candidate. Okay, so this internship is a benefited for intern also, as well as employer also. And one of the very important thing for the intern, see, whenever you will go for that, whenever you will do the internship into that particular company, you will also get to know that this is your dream company or not, or this job is suitable for you or not. Okay, it may happen that, for example, you will get an internship in the Infosys. Okay, but after some time, if that 2 months internship is there, it may happen that in 2 months you will get to know that this is not our type of job. I am not interested for this type of job. This is also you will get to know after internships. Okay, so internships are definitely benefited for interns also, as well as the employers also. Yes, next slide, sir. So need of internships, we'll just go through this short video. Click on this video, sir. It's taking time, I think, sir. It's okay. We'll show this video afterwards. You just come with that next slide. At the end of presentation also, we can show it. Okay. Next slide. Next slide. Okay. So before applying for internship, okay, which things you have to consider it. Okay, so first one is that prepare a neat resume highlighting your skill. Next one is that identify the types of internship. Next one is that collect contact details in industry and connect. Next one, apply and follow up application. And last one is that inform to internship sale for communication. Okay, so before applying internship, first thing you should, anyone can do is that prepare a neat resume highlighting your skill. See, resume is a first impression. So you will, whenever you will communicate with any company for the internships, so what is the first thing you will communicate? You will just send a resume. Okay, so resume is your first impression. Obviously, they are not going to directly meet you in the first phase only. Okay, they will just go through your resume. So in your resume, it should be neat resume. Neat resume means you have to highlight all the projects till now you have done, which are that professional skill. Okay, you have to write it properly, or whatever your objectives are there, you have to mention it properly. Okay, and which are the projects you are going to add it in your resume, it's mandatory that you should know, or you should have a proper knowledge about that project, because interviewer is going to ask based on that project. Okay, so it should not happen that you will add that some n number of projects into your resume and in the interview you will not able to tell anything about that particular project. So it will create a bad impression. So this should not happen. Okay, prepare a neat resume highlighting your skill. Very, very important. Okay, and resume is your first impression. See, companies are first initially in the internship phase, means for the internships company, for example, they are interested for 10 candidates to hire. So what they are going to ask, they are just going to ask us, just send a resume. Okay, so we'll send them near about 100 resume, interested student 100 resume. So based on that, they will just shortlist the 20 resume. Okay, so how they will short the 20 resume, they will just go through that resume, and whatever that, if they are finding it's interesting, okay, this project the students has done, these are the interesting, then definitely they will shortlist the resume. So prepare a neat resume highlighting your skill. It's very important. After that, identify the types of internship. There are different types of internships are there. If you are interested for research internships, it may happen that if you are interested for that professional internships, or it may happen that you are interested for NGO related internships, then identify the types of internships. It's very important according to your interest. After that, collect contact details in industry and connect. Okay, so and again, one of the biggest benefits that internship means interns will get after doing that internship, that they will have a good network. Okay, network means they will come, means they will have a good contacts with them, the company people and all that. So for this, collect contact details in the industry and connect. So for this, you can do one thing. You can just communicate with your senior or the person who knows that they are working into that particular company. If you know them personally or by your friends to friend, you can just communicate with them through the mail or just send them message that I am interested for your guidance and all these things. So collect contact details in the industry and connect. After that, apply and follow up application. Okay, so it's not that means once you will apply and you will just wait for their result. You have to take a follow up also. Okay, but means in a limit. Okay, you have to just send them mail. If they will tell you that wait for a week, then you should wait for a week. It should not happen that second day again you will send to them a mail, third day again you will send them same mails. Okay, they will get irritated. So don't do this thing. So apply and a proper follow. After that, inform to internship sale for the communications. If you find that there may be the help, you can take help from the internship sale from our college. You just inform us. We'll also send them later from your for your reference. So this thing you have to do it before applying for internships. Next slide, sir. So steps to follow. So first, submit application for institute, later with details of contact in industry. Okay, in the next slide, we have taken the format that, okay, our college, our NEP team has prepared a format. So you have to just submit this application for institute later with the details of contacts in industry, okay, to the industries. After that, submit the undertaking signed by you, parent teacher, class teacher and HOD, and submit it along with the selection letter, okay, as well as you have to inform to college also, Okay, so submit undertaking letter. We have prepared that undertaking format also. You can communicate for this undertaking format to your respective coordinator. So undertaking format, but on this undertaking format, you have to take a signature. Means your signature should be there. After that, your parent teacher signature should be there. After that, your class teacher signature should be there. Then HOD, and submit it to your with your selection letter. Then during internship, completion of assignment against the missed lectures assigned by subject teachers. See, it may happen that, see, nowadays there is a, each and everything is online, so there is no question of missing all this assignment because you can manage timing and all that thing. But whenever each and everything will be offline, and if you are visiting your, if you are performing your internship in the company, so there may be the chances that you can miss some assignment. Okay, for this also, we have prepared specific format. You have to just go through that specific format, okay, and just give a assurance to your teacher that I have completed all these assignments, and you have to take a signature of all the teachers in front of that particular assignment. Then next one is that submission of certificates of internships and report to internship coordinator. At the end, after your successful completion of your internships, you have to submit the internship letter to your internship certificate to your coordinator. Next slide, sir. See, this is application format, though it's not visible. Okay, you will get this application format from your respective coordinator. This application, you have to give it to the industry. Okay, next one. Next slide, sir. Then after that, this is undertaken format. Okay, this undertaken format, once you will get internships into particular company, so you have to just give assurance, you have to in the form of undertaking format to the college. Okay, so you have to take the signature of various teacher, that is your signature should be there, parent teacher signature, after that your subject teacher, HODs, all the signature should be here. Next format, sir. Index. Okay, so this is the list of assignment which you miss in the period of your internships. Okay, so when you will come back, then you have to just perform all the assignment. You have to just maintain an index and take your teacher signature also that you have performed the assignment, and you have to submit it to your particular department. Okay, next slide, sir. 1 minute, sir. One slide is missing. Just go back. Types of internship, that slide is missing. That is immediately after the video. Go back, go back, go back. Again, go back. Huh. Next slide. Next slide. Next. Next. Huh. See, types of internship. Previous slide, sir. Previous slide. Types of internships. See, there are different types of internships are there. Paid internships, work research, virtual research, graduational or dissertation, then unpaid internships, partially paid internships. Okay, virtual internship, that is the same. So what is that paid internships? See, in the paid internships, company will give you payment regarding that particular duration. Whenever you will perform your internship into that company for 2 months, 1 month, okay, they will pay you. This is called as a paid internship. Okay, so according to their policy, which are the policy companies are having, based on that they will pay you. The next one is that work research, virtual research, graduational or a dissertation. It may see there are some companies are there, they are just sponsoring as a dissertation, whichever your project you are going to perform as an internship also. Okay, so you can go for that. Again, some work research internships are there. Okay, so many means there are some government organizations are there. They are getting the funding from the government, as well as many means staffs are there. They are also getting the funding from the government to complete particular research. So if you will work on that particular project, that it comes under that your work research. Okay, work research or virtual research. For example, you can see virtual research means you can apply some foreign university also for the internships. If you will do the internship with them, it may happen that they will give a scholarship for your MS program also. Okay, after that, some unpaid internships are there. So in this unpaid internships, companies are just giving you their internship certification completion letter, okay, and as well as that recommendation letter. In this, they are not going to pay you anything. After that, some internships are partially paid internships, means they are just going to give you some minimum amount. Okay, so these are comes under that your partially paid internships and that virtual internship. So all this which are nowadays what you are going on, that comes under that your virtual internships. Next slide. So what are the factors of internships you have to consider? 1 minute, sir. Previous slide. factors of the internships you have to consider. Okay. Now, sir, after this next slide. It's okay, bus. So supervision, design structure, time frame, funding source, third party involvement, location, credit requirements, terms of contract, these are some factors are there. For example, design structures. So you should know that what kind of a structure of that internship they are going to offer you, whether it's a virtual internships or it's a offline internships, okay, whether what are the working hours are there, it's in the night or it's in the day period or it's in the morning. You should know all the design as well as the structure regarding to that internships, okay, specific time period, whether that internship is for one month only specifically or they are going to extend it. You should know all these things before or after getting the internships in detail. After that, funding resource, which are the funding agencies are there, they are going to provide a fund for this particular internships. Then is there any third party involvement is there or not? Location, okay. For example, if we'll just, there are many online opportunities are there. N number of internships are available on AICT portal also. But you should be careful about location. For example, if we'll apply internships and that location is in the Hyderabad. So you have to just think it, is it possible for you to go to that Hyderabad to complete that particular internships or not? Okay, so next one is that credit requirement, what kind of credit they are going to give it regarding that internships. And last one is that what kind of terms of contract company is going to do it with the help with you regarding that internships. So these are some factors you have to consider, okay, before applying the internship. Next slide. Next slide. Okay, so this department internship sales, what is No sir, previous slide. Department internship sales, what they are going to do, they are just going to organize internship drives, okay. They are disseminate information about the upcoming internships and opportunities, as well as they will arrange guest lectures by industry persons, experts, okay. Then support to students during the internship process. So these are the roles which internship, this departmental internship sale will perform it, okay. Okay sir, next slide. Next, we have already gone through this before applying internship. Next slide. Next slide. Next. 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 Okay. So next part, Pansare sir will go with the next part. Pansare sir will just explain you what are the different opportunities are there in the ENTC. Okay. So over to you, Pansare sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, madam. So good morning to all present over here, and today I'm going to explain you about what are the different opportunities in the field of electronics and telecommunication. So in this presentation, I'm going to explain you about very first thing is what is your interested area, how to find what are the different how to find it from the various fields in electronics, okay. Then the different domains that are added in the electronics, and how to grab the opportunity from the various resources. Okay, so when we talk about the electronics, the earlier initial stage and the latest stage, so in between these two we can observe lots of technological changes in this field, and these changes gives us an opportunity to select our career path, right? So let us go through the different domains in electronics, different fields in electronics, as because it consists of when we talk about the hardware part, then the software is included, and the combination of both, okay. So depending upon all these, we'll get so many opportunities. Now how we'll get the opportunities, that I'm going to explain. So the very first slide is internship area of interest. So this is area of your interest, in which field you want to work, right? As because there are so many areas in the electronics, and it is not possible to get expertise in the every area. So you need to find your area of interest. And why I'm telling all these things, because when you first apply to any company for internship, right? So that time company will not directly recruit as directly offer you internship. And one more thing, when they publish their advertisement, that time they used to mention who can apply in their advertisement, and the student from the relevant with the relevant skills and interest in this field can get the opportunity for that internship. Okay, so there is a need to work, to study that particular topic, to select your area of interest of working. Okay, so that you will get opportunity to work to get the internship in the companies. In the field of electronics, as I already told you, it consists of hardware, that is completely core based companies. Some companies are software based and some companies are mixture of both hardware and software. Now what is there in hardware design part? So in that it will work on the IC design, PCB design, component design. Okay, so in component design, it consists of the waveguides, couplers. These are all related to the microwave components, right? So also it consists of the electromagnetic. This field, it requires electromagnetic theory concepts. So this is all regarding the waveguides, couplers and connector switches. And one more thing I want to highlight. Most of the, as this presentation is for SE and TE students, you are going through the basic subjects. You are not known with the technologies that are available in electronics. So as mentioned over here, you don't know about what is waveguide, what is coupler. Okay. Also some more technologies that we are going to see. You are unknown with this technology, but you have to gather the information. You have to study all these technologies and find your area of interest for selecting your internship. So this is about the hardware part. In the software, it consists of completely a software part. Most of the softwares which are there in the electronics that are mentioned over here, it consists of FPGA programming, microcontroller programming, your digital signal processing, VLSI, that is HDL, VHDL verification. Also, it consists of robotics part, MATLAB programming, DSP programming. Okay, so all the programmings that are included in the software part. And in embedded, it consists of mixture of software and hardware. Now, when we see the various technologies that are available, so earlier I just briefed about hardware, software, and the embedded. Now, over here you can see the various technologies that are available in electronics. So, very first one, that is core-based technologies, that is hardware. Okay, as I already told you, in the hardware there is a PCB design, IC design, embedded system design, semiconductor IC-based system. Okay, and the discrete elements like waveguides, couplers, all these things are there in the core-based technologies. So the students, those who are interested in these topics, can select the internship from this core-based technology. Okay, first one. Now, second technology, that is security-based technology. Now, security, very first name, cyber security. Okay, so the students who are interested in working in this area, in cyber working, in blockchain, in ethical hacking, so they can select this technology or this idea or this for their internship. Okay, and obviously this selection will be helpful for you in your future. Third one is remote controlling based technology. In remote controlling based technology, you can study about the cloud computing and Internet of Things. Fourth one, intelligence based technology. In this technology, you'll be learning about the programming, various programming languages, we can say as Python, R programming. So actually these are related to the computer department, but our student, they can do the work in this domain also, as because this ENTC branch is a versatile branch, right? So this student from ENTC, they can work in the computer domains also. So in intelligence based technology, the various programming, it includes languages Python, R programming, machine learning, data science and artificial intelligence. So this is the latest field we can say that is added in the electronics and telecommunication. Fifth one, that is image processing and signal processing. So in image processing and signal processing, we'll be learning about the MATLAB programming, microcontroller programming, and digital signal processing. Okay, so student, please listen to these technologies carefully, because most of the things are unknown to you. Okay, and you are entering into this field. So before entering, choose as per your interest. So the last one is communication based technology. In communication, basically it deals with the networking, like CCNA. Okay, so these are all the technologies available in electronics. You can select any technology as your career path, to select your career path. Now same topic is continued. So these are the latest topics that are included in the field of electronics. So here electronics, it doesn't mean ki only components and PCB, so that circuit diagram. Okay, but with the addition of all these fields, it becomes a smart. So that smart is just because of these added technologies. So it consists of robotics, embedded system, Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, drone development, mechatronics, smart energy system, automation technologies, wireless communication, machine learning. Okay, so these are all the latest technologies. You can select, if you get the opportunity to work in these technologies, so it will always a beneficial thing for you. Now when you apply for internship, then there are certain expectations from the company. As I already mentioned, when you apply, company will check your skills, your interest. So before applying for the internship, you should have some basic knowledge about the ENTC, various subjects in electronic ENTC that are, so as mentioned over here, you can see in the slide, digital design, analog design, signal processing, control systems, IC design, embedded system design. So these are all the things which are mentioned in our curriculum. Okay, so through various subjects, we used to study these subjects. So do not just appear, do not just study for exam, but try to grab most of the things, important things from all the given subjects, because these things will help you a lot in your career. Now this is one field from computer engineering department, that is data science. So many opportunities are also available in this field. Most of the computer student, they used to go through this internship. Our student, they can also select this internship as one of the subject, honor subject, that is introduced for ENTC, that is data science. The student from these students, they can choose this data science internship. Already 2-3 students, they are already doing internship in the data science from our branch. From where you will get the internships. Actually, this slide will Patil sir will explain in detail about these internship portals, but I'm only highlighting the important things, as because most of the internships that are available on these third party websites, these are Internshala, Hello Intern, Latest Intern, 2019, Nokri, Indeed, Fresher World, Shine, etc. Okay, so day before yesterday, I saw the internships that are available in this Indeed site for our students. It was in embedded systems. And the important thing is new internship, the startup culture that is developed during these years, it will provide most of the opportunities for the internships. They usually post their internship requirement on the forums, online forums, or the online websites. On the websites, through these you can select the internship. Now these are the top private sector electronics and telecommunication companies. So here companies are mentioned and the domain in which they are working, like Tata Teleservices, they are working in telecommunication, Vodafone telecommunication, Wipro Services, they are working in wireless networking. I am highlighting only few of the mentioned. Texas Instrument, that is dealing with the ICs, analog and digital electronics. So you can visit to these website for these companies. Try to find opportunities for internship. Okay, as these are very reputed companies. So it's a very good thing when you get the opportunity from these companies. These are some private sector companies. They also provide opportunities for the internship. Again, you need to visit their websites and search for the internship opportunities. Okay, and the last one that is mentioned over here, that is DRDO. So I don't know whether it is public sector or private sector. It comes under the defense services. So this DRDO, some of our students, they are working in DRDO for their final year project. So I saw some opportunities that are available for internship also. So you can visit to this website for this DRDO and try to search the opportunity for internship. So that's all from my side. Now I hand over the session to Dr. Patil sir. He will be explaining he will give more highlight on the internship.
Okay. Thank you, Pansare sir. Thank you, Pansar sir. Very good afternoon, student. Okay. My team member is already explained you a very important part, that is what is the importance of internship, what are the different types of internships, okay, specific internships available for the ENTC, what are the different types of internship for the ENTC student. Okay, this information is given to you, but very important question that is coming into your mind. Okay, we got the information about what is internship, what are the different internship, but how to get this internship? Okay, what are the different ways to get these internships? Okay, so now we are going to talk about what are the different type internships options available and what are the different ways. There are four ways you can get the internship. First, through the government schemes. Second, through the corporate sector or through the company website. Third, third party organization. And four, personally visiting to the industries. Okay, these are the some of the ways I have mentioned here. There are other also, but these are the four major ways to get the internship. Ma'am, next slide. Okay, internship is becoming a very important part of engineering graduate because it connects the student with the industry and it helps the student to acquire the skills necessary for his career in the industry. So regarding that, the government of India is also taking a lot of interest in this activity and a lot of focus is done on for this activity. So AICT, okay, that is the apex body for engineering education. So AICT has created a dedicated portal for this internship program. Okay, so AICT has collaborated with the different companies, invited these companies to give the internship to the student. And all these internships is made available on the common platform that is called AICT internship program. It is a very important program for you because many number of internship is available on this. Let's see what is on this website. Okay, so you can go on this website by putting the website name internship.aict/india.org, or in the Google you can just type internship AICT. The website will come. You click on the website, so this page will come. Okay, so this is what a dedicated internship portal created by AICT specifically for the engineering student. Okay, now here you can see that there are different internships available. Ma'am, can you please go down? Okay, so there are different sections has been made depending on what background the student comes. Okay, for example, you can see that if the student is from the computer section, then there are Cisco internship is available. It doesn't mean that these internships are only related to the computer, but they have segregated the internship depending on the need of the student. Similarly, for the mechanical student, there are oil and gas internships. For ENTC also, you can have IoT internships and multiple internships available. But as I said that these are, aisa nahi hai ki, is it not like that ki, it is only for mechanical or computer. ENTC students also having the internship in this. Let's take a one example. Let's go to the corporate internships. Yes. Okay. Under, you can choose any type of internship. You need to go to each and every type of internship. Just click on that and you can see that number of internship opportunities available there. Now, depending on your liking and what internship you want to do, okay, you just click on any one of them. Okay, now let's take one example. Okay, now I'm going to explain you how to apply, what is need to be done. Okay, go down, ma'am. Okay, we can take one example here. Let's take a example that upskill program in embedded and application OAuth. Okay, so when you click on that, you will get all the details about that what is the date on which that internship has been put on this website, what is the closing date for this. Okay, what is the duration of this internship, whether this internship is a paid or not paid. Okay, so this information is available here. Okay, this is a short, you can see that very first part will give you the short details about this. Ma'am, can you please go down? Okay, and below here you can get the details about the company, about the program, which student can apply for this, what are the content of this program, all the information is available here. Now let's see how to apply and also who can apply. Now this is for second and third year, okay, and duration is 280 hours, okay, and number of openings. Now let's see how to apply. Okay, now this internship is funded by Government of India, that Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. So this program is funded by Government of India, so it's a free of cost. Okay, now let's see how to apply. Where you have to click apply. Now when you click on the apply now button, okay, it will take you to the login page. Okay, so very first thing that is you need, as you know that for other website, is that you need to create the login credential. Okay, so let's see how to create the login credential. You have to click on the register now. Click on the register now. It is on the bottom. Yeah, yes. When you click on the register now, it will ask some information. The very first page will contain the basic information about you, like whether your institute is AICT affiliated organization or non-AICT. Of course, we are affiliated to AICT. So first tab you need to select. Then you need to put up your institute name. Okay. And then you need to put up your student ID. Now what the student ID should you put? You need to put up your university PRN number, because that is going to be fixed throughout your engineering program. Then first name, middle name, last name, then your state, city, contact number and email. Contact number and email are very important, because whatever the communication that is going to happen on this contact number and email, or whether you want to change the password and all these things, that is going to happen on this. Okay. And then you need to put up your password, then security questions, then I'm not robot, and then submit and register. When you click on the register, they will send you one link on mail for verification of email. So you need to verify your email and all these things. Okay, so your login ID and password is created. Okay, so can you now apply for this internship? No. This is just basic information is created. Again, by using this information, you need to log in again, and then you need to put up the other information, like which year you are in, what is your program, semesters, other skills, all this information. Basically, you need to complete your profile. Just now, your primary information is collected for creating the login ID and password. Now, once you got the login ID and password, you again need to go to your profile, and you need to complete the profile by updating your education, your skills, and all these things. Once you complete your profile, now you can apply for that internship, any internship you want. So you can go to the any internship page and then click on the apply now. So you can directly applied process will be done. Then now once you applied, then this data will send to the company which is conducting these internships, and they will communicate about the selection process. Okay, so you need to follow the selection process. Okay, so these are the process. It's very important. Okay, all of you must register for this AICT internship program. Number of internship is available not only for your domain but multi-domain. Number of domain is there, so you have lot of option to choose. Okay, so make sure that all of you register to this AICT internship program. Okay, similarly, Government of India is having other internship program also. For example, NITI internship scheme is also there. So you can go to the NITI website, and they are also having internship scheme also there. Then there is a Ministry of External Affairs internship program is also there. Now this internship is for the graduate student who has been passed out. Then the internship is available also under Women and Child Development Ministry internship program. Now this is basically related to the social internship. Okay, instead of technical, they are more focused on the social. So if somebody want to do the internship or have the liking toward the social issues, and they want to do something in there, then they can go for this kind of internship. Similarly, Department of for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade internship is also having the internship. Okay, we are going to share this PPT, and these are linked with the website. So you just need to click on the heading, and directly it will take you to that website, and then there you can get the more information. Okay, so these are the internship by the government. Okay, now let's see the private sector. Okay, yes, many companies, mostly multinational companies, they have dedicated internship program, not at local level but at global level. So number of internship is available. Very first program they run for the student is called Global Internship Program. Second they run is called Student Dissertation Scheme. Third, Career Page. And fourth, Visiting Student Research Program. Now let's see one by one what are these. Let's go to the Global Internship Program. Okay, let's take one example of this. Okay, Global Internship Program. Okay, many companies are running this internship program. This is just one example. Okay, we have taken the example of Tata. Okay, Tata is running the Global Internship Program. Okay, so you can go to their page, and the details are mentioned on their page, and application process is also mentioned on that page. Go through the details, check whether this internship program is suitable for you or as per liking, and then follow their procedure and do the application. Okay, so this is what Global Internship Program. Similarly, other Infosys is also having, all major companies are also running this Global Internship Program. Second one is what? Student Dissertation Scheme. Okay, here what you do, okay, you complete one project, you take one project there, okay, you complete the project and you write the thesis on that project. So basically you are going to do the project given by the industry, you complete that project, and based on that project you write the dissertation scheme. Now let's go to that website. Okay, please click on the Student Dissertation Scheme. Yes, now this is one example. Again, as I said, that many companies are also running this Student Dissertation Scheme. Okay, it's a wonderful opportunity. You also get the chance to work on live project and you write the thesis there. Okay, so this is what by Sandvik. Similarly, other companies are also having the same kind of programs here. Okay, so you can see that many companies are having dedicated page for the student. Okay, and they want maximum graduate to enroll to their company, because they know that a lot of potential is available in the graduate, and it also helps them to identify the future prospective employee. Okay, so under them there are graduate program is also there, and thesis project is also there. Graduate program, as I said, that it is a global internship part, and thesis project, as I mentioned, that thesis internship. Okay, so this is by Sandvik. Other companies are also having that, so just go through that and you will get the information. Third, career page. Every industry is having the career page. Okay, and some jobs are specially for the student. Okay, so you can go to their career page, and there also you can see the number of openings. Please click on the career page. Let's take one example. Yes, this is the company Schaeffler. Okay, and they on their career page they have special section for the student. Okay. Okay, go down. Yes. So you can see that this is a special section for the student, and they have all the information mentioned here. Okay, and you just follow that information, and then as per their instruction, you can apply for that this kind of program also. Okay, next. Okay. Sir, go to the PPT. Okay. Fourth one is the student who are more inclination toward the research. Okay, they want to go into the research. For them also, there are some research internship program is also available. You can see that this internship is by Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, and specifically it is in the astronomy and astrophysics. Student who are more inclined toward this kind of astronomy or astrophysics, they can apply. Their procedure start in the January. Okay, so you can go to their website. Please click on the link. Okay, yes. This is by Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. Okay, all the information is given on here, and they also mentioned the program duration. Okay, this is between June to August. Actually, the process is over for this, but in the coming year, you can apply here. Okay, apply. Okay, so these are the programs by the private companies. Okay. So the second option is that you can visit the company website, and under the company website, different types of internship program is available. Okay, next. Now we also seen that there are you can apply through the government scheme also. You can apply through the private companies also. Okay, next. Now what is the third option? See, we have to look for every way that can be possible. Okay, now let's go for third option. Next. Yes, third party organization. Now here what we do, okay, like here you are not directly contacting the organization which is going to give the internship. No, you are contacting some middle organization, okay, which collect the information and all this thing, and through them you are going to approach the company. Okay, so what are the different ways for through the first one, internship website, and second one is what, self-sponsored internship program. Okay, so here you are not directly connecting to the companies. Okay, here you are going through some middle channel. Okay, now let's see the internship website. What are the different internship website? Is it already Pansari sir has mentioned some of the internship website. Okay, so next slide. Yes, very important and very useful is Google. Okay, Google will give you the which and every information. You can put up your liking, like in which area you want looking for internship, and you and country or place you can put up there. You will get the information. Second one is what, LinkedIn ID. Okay, I hope all of you have created your LinkedIn ID. See, LinkedIn ID is a page. Okay, it is not a social networking page. It is more like a networking between the professionals. Okay, so there, so you can create the LinkedIn ID. Okay, people who are working in the industries or which are working, they are all connected there. So when you log in the LinkedIn ID, there is one tab, jobs. Okay, you click on the jobs and you put up the internship and the area. So you can directly connect, you will get the more information there. Okay, because that information is directly put it by the people working in that organization. Suppose someone is working in the Tata, so he knows that there are some openings for internship in Tata. So he's already on the LinkedIn profile. So through his profile, you post that we are looking internship in our organization. So you can directly connect with that. Okay. Third one is what, Intershala. Okay, as you already know, we already collaborated with the Intershala, and you are already getting the mails and all these things about the different internships. They are also having very good number of internships on their website. Okay. Fourth one is what, Freshers World. Okay, it is again very popular website among the freshers. Okay, and this mostly the jobs for the freshers is listed. Also, they have internship page also. So on the freshersworld.com also you can get the internship opportunity. Similarly, other internship website is also available. Okay, but just word of cautious is that always be aware of the fake and fraudulent internship offer while applying the online, because you are applying online, so you may not know who is sitting on the other side, whether that offer is genuine. So you have to make sure that before accepting the offer, that offer is coming from the genuine source. So this care you have to. Okay, so this is using the websites. Next. Similarly, some paid internship kind of courses which are on the internship, that is also available. Now, benefit of this is that, see, anyway, you want to acquire some skills, you want to do some courses, okay? Like you want to do some skills upgrading program in the embedded. So if you go to the any normal organization, you just get the certificate of courses, completion of course. But here what happened? You are not getting the certificate of completion of course, but you're also getting the internship certificate. So tomorrow when you're applying for any industry, you can show some experience through these internships, okay? So many programs is available, okay? These are, I think many of them are paid programs because they are conducting courses through also. So it is your choice whether you want to go to here. If you are planning to do... the internship part. So you will get both the benefit, okay? So it is your liking, your choice, whether you want to go for this or not, okay? Next. It is always not, see, it is not only necessary ki we always have to start with the big organization, okay? Yes, big organization has their own benefit, but you can also start with your small organization. And what happened, small organization doesn't do any publicity or doesn't have website, big website, or they don't do the display the ads or no that. They take the student, but you need to personally approach them. Now, what is the benefit of starting with the smaller organization is also that in smaller organization, you get a lot of things to learn. Because in big organization, everything is department segregated, okay? So people working in one department do not know what is happening in other department. But in smaller organization, you get a chance to work in each and every department. So it will really help you to develop your skills, okay? So this is also good, okay? Now, how to approach the small organization? There you need to personally visit there, okay? Now, some of you, as I said, Raibullah sir has already mentioned that maybe someone from your family may be working in that organization. So you can contact him, you can ask him whether any opening in there, and through that contact, you can get the, internships. Second, you can personally visit to that industry and you can drop your resume. Okay, now luckily we are living in the MIDC Pune, and Pune has number of MIDCs in here. So many small scale, medium scale industries are there in the Pune. So you have a lot of options available. So you can directly visit that organization and you can drop the resume, or you can ask them, okay, I'm coming for this. So if they permit, you can talk to the person. Also, we are at this, we are also going to organize some institute level drives. Okay, through that also you can apply. And fourth one is that, you know that there are placement agencies, okay? So you can approach through that placement agencies. But many of the agencies, they're operating for smaller organization, okay? Small scale or medium scale, okay? So these are the ways are available. Now it is your choice, okay? You have to make sure that you have to go through each and every. You have to take the benefit of each and every possible option available, okay? So I hope now you understood that what are the different options available, and I hope you can take benefit of all these options and get the internships, okay? Very first thing that you need to do is register for the AICT internship drive, okay? And also, okay, that is the first priority you have to do. And then you can apply through other channel also, okay? So this is all about, okay? Sir, you want to show the video to the students, sir? Can we show the video to the students?
Yes, sir.
Let's see the video, okay, which explains the importance of the internship, okay? Why it is an important part of your engineering career, that is explained here.
If you're looking for a job, it can seem like everything requires 3 to 5 years of experience. In fact, experience can be the crucial factor in who gets hired and who doesn't. Employers love experience. But data also shows that post-secondary education is essential for higher lifetime earnings. So, how do you get both education and experience? Internships. According to a 2012 study by the National Association of Colleges and Employers, 59% of businesses hired their paid interns as new full-time employees. This may be why 65% of 25 to 32-year-olds in the labor force said more work experience while in school would have helped them get the job they wanted. By cultivating the professional networks and skills you need to succeed, internships can really improve your employability, regardless of what you're majoring in. In fact, a recent Auburn University study showed that interning in a career field could be even more important than majoring in that field when it comes to getting a job interview. And while unpaid internships were a big thing in the past, the U.S. Department of Labor now issues legal guidelines that encourage employers to pay interns for their work. In fact, both national and local data indicate that the overwhelming majority of internships are paid. So, intern early and intern often. And if you're a rising college junior or senior looking for an internship, check out the Kentuckiana Works College to Career Program. It places good interns with good companies in paid internships. To be considered for a 2015 summer or fall internship, apply now at c2clouisville.org.
Hello, sir. Take one common snap.
Okay. I request all the participants to please switch on your video. Okay, Bimo, because we okay. Do you have any question before that? Anybody is having the questions regarding this session? If you have any doubt, you can speak up here so we can discuss that. Okay, if anybody is having. If you have doubt, you can raise your hand and you can ask. So, ma'am, so I think we can. Okay. Please switch on your video. Okay, so we can have one group photo.
Students, if you have any doubt, please raise your hand. Any doubt, if you have, raise your hand. Sir, we'll check their doubts first. Then we'll take photograph, please.
Yes, sir, yes. I request all students, if you are having any doubts, feel free to ask the questions so that our team members will explain your doubts. You just raise the hand and unmute yourself.
You can directly unmute and ask your question.
Maybe questions related to the process. Yes.
Yes,
Murtaza. Hello, good morning. Good morning, everyone. Sir, actually, I'm Murtaza Bharucha from ENTC, SENTC. Sir, I just wanted to know that now as we have come to the end of the session, so sir, as you mentioned about the different websites and the different portals or the ways through which we can apply for internships, so is it that now we ourselves have to do all that and to go for all the process, or do we have to, you know, send a resume or take help from the coordinators as well, from the internship coordinators, college, the people, the staff members of the college?
Sir, Pansar sir, you want to answer or?
Actually, I'm not able to hear.
Okay, him, sir.
What he said.
Sir, I wanted to know that if we want to apply for an internship or if we are looking out for an internship, so do we ourselves only need to go and apply on these websites, or do we also have to contact the internship coordinator from a college? Or whoever is, in charge. So will they also help us out, or we ourselves have to you know, search for the internships?
Actually, in both ways. You can do it with your own also, and from our side, we'll also help you. We can arrange the drives, or we can intimate you about the internships that are available on which website. So these things we can do. And actually, this is online mode right now. You can select. You can directly join to the internship, but when there is an offline that time you have to intimate all the things to us, and you have to take permission from the college, because you are not attending the college and joining the internship. Okay, so that will be the different scenario. Right now you can directly join, and where you are joining, that only you have to inform us.
Basically, Murtaza, see, okay, the things will going to happen in a parallel. Means what happened, we are also going to identify the companies, okay, and bring you to the institute, and at the same time, you are also on your side are going to be there. So simultaneously, both the things you have to do. You have also need to apply from your side also, and also at the same time, we are going to be called the companies also, okay. So whichever the opportunity come first, then you can apply for that, okay. And if any help is needed regarding that, we are available there, okay.
Just okay, in sir. Addition to this, Murtuza, as this internship information filling and everything is online, you can do yourself, and you can, if it is in that case, if any help is required, you can ask the coordinator, a corresponding coordinator of your department, and you should be in communication with the internship coordinator, because this record and whatever is the achievement of the student, it will be this internship is one of the achievement of our student, so we supposed to record it on document also. So whenever you got the opportunity in some industry, whatever the documents available with you, that those documents also you required to submit to the department also.
Okay, yes sir.
Hello, yeah, I hope you are, yes, getting this, yes. Yeah, yeah,
yes sir. Okay, I got
thank
it
you.
Thank you, okay, sir.
Any other question?
Hello, sir.
Yes, yes, please. Yeah, yeah, you are,
yes,
audible.
Sir, yeah, I am right now doing an internship. So, what documentation I have to do for college? I mean,
I think whenever you got the internship opportunity, some kind of document you might have received,
yes,
from the industry. So that document,
yes,
only okay, you required to submit to the corresponding coordinator.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Yeah.
We have created one Google form, and you can fill up that form. You can attach that letter to in that form. So,
okay, sir.
So that
will. So where can I find that?
Who is doing? Where you are doing your internship?
So, sir, that company's name is VTC. So it's based in Punjab, Mohali.
Okay.
By my brother's friend, so I gave interview and all, and so I just got selected. I just started it, means on 23rd of this month.
Okay.
Very good.
Yeah, they might have given some letter to you.
Yes, sir. They have given, yeah, internship letter.
Yeah, just that letter you supposed to give to the coordinator, so that we can keep as a record. And if some closing report, if it is there, you are submitting to the industry, same report, yes, you can submit to the department also. So it will be
okay,
useful for our documentation purpose only.
Okay, sir, sure.
And at the end, whatever the completion certificate they will give, that is important actually, that they have to submit it in the college.
Yes,
completion,
yes, yes.
Internship, successful internship completion certificate.
Okay.
Yeah. That completion certificate also, mm-hmm, you submit to the corresponding coordinator.
Coordinators,
okay,
that's the main thing.
Yes, yes, yes.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Any other question? Ask your doubts.
I think, I hope there are no questions.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So, everyone, please switch on your camera so that we'll take a group photograph.
Sir, I think they are not able to switch on the camera, sir, I think.
Okay.
That is, I think some, the, you need to do some changes in the meeting options, sir. Allow camera. We, you need to do the allow camera to everyone, sir. Yes, I have done, sir. I have done the, I done the changes, sir. Now they can switch on the camera. Yes. Yes. Now all of you can switch on the camera. I hope. Okay. Yes. Good.
Patil sir, Wagmar, to me, kya par kab photos?
Yes. Yes. Oh, yes, sir. Me pan geto.
Make sure all of you switch on the camera.
All of you switch on your camera.
Yes, taken, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, student, for attending this session, and I hope you take the benefit of this and try to get the internship. Thank you very much, Ali.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Raibuli, sir. Wag, madam. Dr. Patil, sir.
Yes, thank you, everyone, and all the best.
Yeah. Now, students may leave the session. Download ke liye, sir, attendance?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, all students may leave the session. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, students. Now we can leave the meeting.
Recording stop ke liye, sir. Nice. Stop recording.
Yes,
and you can end from your side, sir.
Yes.